Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. Today we are going to see the two topics, Jacobian and functional dependence and problems on those topics. It is very very important, definite question you can expect from Jacobian and functional dependence. Now let us see the definition. If u and v are functions of two variables x and y, then the determinant dou u by dou x, what is given? U is a function of x and y and v is also function of x and y. Then the Jacobian is defined as Jacobian of the independent variable u comma v with respect to the independent variable x and y, that is denoted by this and defined by this, the determinant of dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y. It can also be written as dou u by dou x, dou v by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou v by dou y. Because it is determinant, whether you write A or A transpose, no problem. Okay, and it is to be read as Jacobian of u comma v with respect to the independent variables x comma y. It can be extended for more variables, three variables. For three variables, it is defined like this. If u is a function of x, y, z, v is a function of x, y, z, w is also function of x, y, z, then dou u v w, that is Jacobian of u v w with respect to x, y, z is defined like this. Consider this variable u first and finish off all the independent variables, that is dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z. Okay, then next consider v, then finish off with all the three independent variables. Similarly with respect to w, third variable, then with respect to x, y, z. Okay, this is the definition. Now properties of Jacobian. If j is Jacobian of u comma v with respect to x comma y, and j dash is Jacobian of x comma y with respect to u comma v, then j into j dash is equal to 1. Okay, so now we have to prove this. What is given? Consider u is a function of x comma y and v is also another function of x comma y. If you solve these two, can you write x as a function of u comma v and y as a function of another function of u comma v? Yes, we can write. I'll give you one example. X is equal to r cos theta. Already we have seen in the previous class. Y is equal to r sin theta. Then you can solve these two and write x squared, r squared is equal to x squared plus y squared, and theta is equal to tan inverse of y by x, right? So now I have written, given x and y as functions of r comma theta. Now r and theta are functions of x comma y. We can write like this only. The same concept I have applied here. And u comma, now what is there? You write as it is, that is like a tree diagram. You write u is a given function of x and y. Now we have written x as function of u comma v. Similarly, y as a function of u comma v. Similarly, v is a function of x and y given, and we can write u as a function of u and x as a function of u and v, y as a function of u and v. Now you find dou u by dou u. What is dou u by dou u? Your different partial differentiation of u with respect to u, which is 1, right? Partial differentiation of u with respect to the same variable u. Now from u you have to come to this u. So dou u by dou x into dou x by dou u. Through x you can come, or through y you can come. So dou u by dou y into dou y by dou u. This is our du by dou u by dou u. Similarly, dou u by dou v. From u you have to come to v through x or through v. But u with respect to v is constant. By partial differentiation of one variable with respect to the other variable is 0. Okay. So dou u by dou x into dou x by dou v plus dou u by dou v, sorry, dou y into dou y by dou v, right? Similarly, what is dou v by dou u is also 0. So dou, from v you have to come to u. So dou v by dou x into dou x by dou u plus dou v by dou y into dou y by dou u, right? Similarly, dou v by dou v is 1, which is dou v by dou x into dou x by dou v plus dou v by dou y into dou y by dou v, right? So these four we are going to use now. These four results. Now what is J and J dash? What is J? J is a Jacobian of u comma v with respect to x comma y. So if you write like this, Jacobian of u comma v with respect to x comma y. So dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, then dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y. What is Jacobian J dash? What is J dash? Jacobian of x comma y with respect to u comma v. So dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v, dou y by dou u, dou y by dou v. If you multiply, what will you get? Dou u by dou x into dou x by dou u plus dou u by dou y into dou u by dou v. First row, first column, you will get 1. The next value 0. Then 0, 1. If you multiply, you will get this. Therefore, J into J dash is 1. This is what we wanted to prove, the property. First property. Next, second property, chain rule for Jacobians. This is for. Chain rule for Jacobians. Actually, U is a function of R and S. R and S are in turn functions of X and Y. Similarly, V is a function of R and S. And R and S are in turn functions of X and Y. So u and v are functions of x and y, we can say. So we can find out Jacobian of u comma v with respect to x comma y, but through r comma s you have to find out. That is the logic. Okay. So let us consider the RHS first. Dou u comma v, that is Jacobian of u comma v with respect to r comma s into dou r comma s with respect to x comma y. Is equal to, what is Jacobian of u comma v with respect to r comma s? So dou u by dou r, dou u by dou s, dou v by dou r, dou v by dou s. This is the first one, right? Into, second one is dou r by dou x, dou r by dou y. And dou s by dou x, dou s by dou y. If you expand, what will you get? Dou u by dou r into dou r by dou x plus, that is first row, first column. So first plus dou u by dou r into dou r by dou x plus dou u by dou s into dou s by dou x, right? This is first row, first column. First row, second column. Dou u by dou r into dou r by dou y plus dou u by dou s into dou s by dou y. Second row, first column, that is dou v by dou r into dou r by dou x plus dou v by dou s into dou s by dou x. Now dou v, the second row, second column, so dou v by dou r into dou r by dou x. Second row, first column, dou r by dou y plus dou v by dou s into dou s by dou v, dou y. Now what is this? See, from u through x, dou u by dou r, dou u by dou r into dou r by dou x here. From u to x through r, first one. Dou u by dou s by dou x. So from u to x through s. Okay, what is this one? Dou u by dou x. Similarly, other things also you can see. Dou u by dou x, RHS we have considered. Dou u by dou x, then dou u by dou y. Second will be dou u by dou y. Similarly, dou v by dou x and dou v by dou y. What is this? Jacobian of u comma v with respect to dou of u comma v with respect to x comma y. This is what we wanted to prove. This is our LHS, right? We have proved this. Even the proofs are important, even both the properties are important, okay? Now let us see some problems. If x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, find the Jacobian of x comma y with respect to r comma theta. So dou x comma y by dou r comma theta is equal to, by definition, it is dou x by dou r, dou x by dou theta, dou y by dou r, dou y by dou theta. Is equal to what? What is dou x by dou r? Cos theta. Dou x by dou theta minus r sin theta. Dou y by dou r sin theta. Dou y by dou theta r cos theta. Expand this r into cos square theta minus of one more minus is there, therefore it will become plus r into sin square theta. You take r outside, cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is equal to r. R is the answer. Okay, next question. This is question number 2. If x is equal to r cos phi, y is equal to r sin phi, z is equal to z. What is this? Dou of xyz with respect to r phi z, which is equal to dou x by dou r, dou x by dou phi, dou x by dou z. Similarly, dou y by dou r, dou y by dou phi, dou y by dou z. Dou z by dou r, dou z by dou phi, dou z by dou z. So, if you substitute, if you find out all these partial differential, you will get cos phi minus rho sin phi. Then 0, because z is no z in x, dou x by dou z is 0. Then sin phi, rho cos phi, 0, 0, 0, 1. Which is equal to, if you simplify, you will get rho. Rho is the answer. This is called cylindrical coordinates. X, Y, Z are Cartesian coordinates, no? So, this R, Phi, Z is called cylindrical coordinate system. So, for this change of variables, in the next year, M2, you will get change of coordinates. This will be useful for that. Okay. And this one, you can take it as a homework. Here, you have to find out Jacobian of U, V, W with respect to X, Y, Z. You find out. You will get this. And in that, it will be a function of x, y, z, right? In that, you directly substitute whenever at the point. What is the point? 1, comma, minus 1, comma, 0. In this only, you will get in terms of x, y, z. So, wherever you find x, replace it by 1. Wherever you find y, replace it by minus 1. Wherever you get z, you replace it by 0. You will get, you can simplify. Here itself, you need not expand. First itself, you can substitute. Dou uv is w. Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z. Okay, in this itself you find out, substitute the points, then you expand. Answer is 20 you should get. Okay, if you get any doubt, you can post it in the comment box. I will answer. Next is functional relationship. This is very, very important topic. Actually, what you mean here is, you can read this. See, u is a function of x, y, z. V is a function of x, y, z. U is a function of x, y, z. And V is a function of x, y, z. And W is also a function of x, y, z. If you want to find out any relationship is there between u, v, w, are they related? If you want to find out, is there any relationship, or they are that is dependent? There is any relationship means one is depending on the other, right? So whenever you see these words, functionally independent, functionally dependent, functional relationship, all those things, if you want to find out, you immediately, you should be able to find out the Jacobian. Immediately you find the Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z. If it is equal to 0, yes, they are related. If the Jacobian is 0, there is a relationship between them. They are related. That means they are dependent. If they are related, one is some, at least one function is depending on the other one. If the Jacobian is not equal to 0, there is no relation. No relation between them. or they are independent, you can see. Got it? So let us see some problems in this. If u is equal to x plus y, 1 x plus y by 1 minus xy, v is equal to tan inverse of, these are the functions. First you are asked to evaluate this, then because you are finding Jacobian, immediately you will come to know that whether they are functionally related or not. Let us find out the Jacobian first. Dou u comma v, dou x comma y. By definition, what is this? Dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y. Right? This is equal to, when you substitute, when you differentiate this, you have here, you have x in the numerator, y also in the denominator. X in the denominator. So d by dx of first, if you find out this u by v, what is the formula? V squared, always you write the denominator squared first, then you start with v du by dx minus u into dv by dx. So please remember this formula. This is what we are going to apply in the first one, dou by dou x of u, dou u by dou x, because you have both numerator denominator function of x. So u by v formula, if you find out and simplify, you will get 1 plus y square divided by 1 minus xy the whole square, right? Similarly, here you will get 1 plus x square divided by 1 minus xy the whole square. And v is tan inverse of x, tan inverse of y. So by the formula, by differentiation of tan inverse of x, 1 by 1 plus y x square and 1 plus 1 by y square. If you expand this, what will you get? 1 plus y squared by 1 minus xy the whole squared into 1 by 1 plus y squared minus of 1 by 1 plus x squared into 1 plus x squared by 1 minus xy the whole squared. So this term will get cancelled. These two terms will get cancelled. You will be getting 1 by 1 minus xy the whole squared minus 1 by 1 minus xy the whole squared, which is nothing but 0. Because the Jacobian is zero, they are related. That means there is some relationship between them. Therefore, you can write u and v are functionally related. Functionally related. Now, how will you find out the relation? Consider v. It is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y. There is a formula for this, right? It is tan inverse of x plus y by 1 minus xy. What is this x plus y by 1 minus xy? It is nothing but u. So tan inverse of u. So we started with v and we found that it is u. So this is the relationship between v and u. Okay. There is one more question. Use Jacobian to prove that the functions u, x, y, z, etc. Not independent. They are not independent means what? There is some relationship between them. Find the relationship between them. So how will you find out? Whenever you see these words, relationship, independent, dependent, all those things, immediately you have to find out the Jacobian. Here they are mentioned, but even if it is not mentioned, you should be able to identify. So dou uvw, Jacobian of uvw with respect to xyz. Okay, so if you find out dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, by definition dou u by dou z. Similarly, dou v by dou x, dou v by dou y, dou v by dou z. And dou w by dou x, dou w by dou y, dou w by dou z. If you substitute, directly differentiate all simple functions only. I'm going to write directly 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1. And 2x, 2y minus 2z, 2z minus 2y. If you simplify, you will be getting 0. Therefore, Jacobian is 0. Therefore, what? Therefore, u and v are related. Sorry, u, v, w are related. Or related or not independent. They are asked to prove that not independent. You can write not independent or related also. So now if you find out u into v. So x plus y minus z into x minus y plus z. If you expand this, you will get x squared minus y squared minus z squared plus 2yz, which is our w. Therefore, uv is equal to w is the relationship between them. Okay. So if you get Jacobian zero, definitely you will be able to find out the relationship between them. Okay. And now you can take this as a homework. If u is equal to x by y and v is equal to x plus y by x minus y, evaluate this and are they related or not. Right. Thank you so much for listening.